In this third screencast on how to study, I'm going to talk about a few additional approaches. In the first two, I talked about practice testing and distributed and interleaved practice. And again, these are based on studies in the literature. Here I'm going to talk about some additional approaches: elaborative interrogation, self-explanation, the idea of studying in various locations instead of just one, and then the idea of not taking notes in class, but trying to take notes after class. I want to also point out the studies have shown that some things do not work well. Highlighting the text and underlining turns out not to be very effective. Rereading the same chapter also is one of the less effective techniques. Writing summaries of what you read also turns out to be less effective than these other techniques that I've talked about. So, elaborative interrogation. What this means is essentially asking why. So the idea, when you're reading, generate an explanation for some fact. In other words, this is not from the instructor, but it's you generating the explanation. And then, in addition, look at similarities between this information and other related entities, and look at also differences. This approach certainly is probably more useful for discrete factual information, but a number of studies have indicated it does improve retention. The next one to look at, again briefly, is self-explanation. The idea here is, if, for example, you're reading something, how does the new information relate to the information that you already know? So you want to relate information. The other is, when you're solving problems, that you actually explain the steps. Why do we do this step? Why do we take a derivative here? Explaining the steps when solving the problem, the self-explanation, has shown to improve retention. And let's just look at results from one study. So the idea here is, initially when learning the material, the first, problem-solving accuracy in this particular case actually looked pretty similar. But when tested later, now there's a dramatic advantage to doing self-explanation while you're solving the problem. This is for doing the explanation after having solved the problem. That certainly helps. And again, a dramatic difference in this study if there was no explanation. Well, let's look at this idea. And again, probably contrary to what advice has commonly been, of find one place to study and study in that place. Instead, it says sometimes study in the library, sometimes study on the floor, sometimes study at a desk in your house or in your dorm room. Study in various locations actually is found to improve retention. And the last one says, don't take notes during class. For best performance, instead of doing this, it says, when you leave class, take notes, and retrieving the information is going to actually mean retaining it better. One of the problems of course, taking notes, becoming a stenographer, is very difficult to both listen and write things down. And so studies indicate it's better to try and take notes after class. So these are just brief explanations of some of these approaches to studying that, if you incorporate into your studying, hopefully improve your retention of material.